Hey everybody, Bruce Elgord here with a short video on how to add extensions into Visual Studio Code. The instructions work the same for both Windows and Macintosh, so just know that, all right? So I'm going to launch Visual Studio Code on my PC, and there it is, okay? Now, on the left sidebar over here, you see we have, what, five icons, okay? The icon at the bottom here, if you hover your mouse over it, right, it says extensions. So if I click on extensions, it brings up a panel here. And if you type in Python, okay, you're going to see here that it comes up with this one called Python. This is, and actually, if you just click on it once, you'll see here that this is the extension that you need to install for this class. It's the primary extension that's going to add Python functionality to Visual Studio Code. So there it is. It's by Microsoft. It's been downloaded a lot. It's got really good ratings. One thing you want to do when you install an extension is to make sure that it has good user feedback, right? Because you don't want to install low-rated extensions. They probably have a lot of bugs and stuff like that, right? So I'm going to click on install, and now Python is ready to go. It's part of Visual Studio Code. Some extensions may ask you to relaunch Visual Studio Code. They may provide another, you know, icon here or button or something like that. Throughout the course, I may be asking you to install other extensions, so just know that you click on this icon in the left sidebar, you type in the name of the extension, verify that it's the correct one, and then click on install. I hope this video helped. If you have any questions, catch me on Slack.